I got a helper. Can you say hi, Brinley? Haven't made a video in a while again. Sorry about that. Kind of left a little teaser in the last video about I got another tractor. Well, I'm going to save the excuses. I mean, busy pretty much. So, haven't started cutting hay. Actually, just getting the hay bind out today. I just hooked up the round baler. I'm going to cut today here at home. Today is Friday the 19th of June. Before we get to the new tractor, I want to give you a little bit of kind of, I don't know if I talked about it much, but the 70, 60, the reason why I haven't started haying, and we've had beautiful weather for it. I wish I could have started. But the tractor that I round bale with, the 70-60, I guess at the shop right now, or it's at a guy's house he's tearing it apart. He's got the tractor split in half and he's putting a new clutch in it. And we went through, put enough money into it so already. So that's kind of why I haven't had a round baling tractor. So I've been kind of scratching my head on what I'm going to do. But I need to get started haying. I mean, it's, like I said, we've had probably a good week and a half of solid dry weather. First part of the weeks, it was kind of cool, 60s, but this last probably 6 days, it's been 80 degrees. And it's killing me because I don't have any hay down. Now there's a chance of rain late tomorrow night and chance of rain Sunday. And then first part of next week, but then it looks good again. So my original plan, I wanted to start cutting at least here at home early so I can try and get a third cutting, because I usually end up selling the second and third cutting. I usually square bill that and I usually end up selling that. So I wanted to get going early, but with the 70-60 going down, my round baling tractor, kind of put a damper on things. So I've been kind of in a dilemma, really. So this is going to be wet hay that I'm cutting today. I'm going to wrap it tomorrow, bale it and wrap it tomorrow is what the plan is. But we'll see how that goes. Now, the new tractor I got, right there she is. Alice Chalmers 710 garden tractor. I actually kind of been looking for one. It's got a rototiller on it. You want to go in the house, Bryn?
Yeah.
Okay. It's got a rototiller on it, which is perfect for the wife's garden. Needs a new seat, but I've actually been looking for one kind of here and there. And we were over at my wife's aunt's. And she's got a couple old Alice Chalmers. She's actually got a Alice Chalmers 170 with a loader on it that's diesel that I told her I'd be interested in whenever she decides she wants to sell it. She uses it for brush hogging and stuff like that. And I seen this sitting in her garage, and I'm like, no kidding. So I ended up buying it off her. And it runs. It hasn't ran in like 3 years. I got it home, cleaned everything up, put new gas in it, fuel filters and stuff, and they ran good. So, yeah, it's hold on, Brinley. It's in good shape. She's always kept it inside, so that's the new tractor I was talking about. When I said I got a new tractor. So that was back probably about at least a week ago.
and I just kind of been doing odds and ends things, getting caught up on things, spraying, spreading fertilizer. We spread some fertilizer on the corn, over top of the corn. I mean, the corn's up and everything. So, just trying to get caught up on that stuff. I actually got to spray the last field of soybeans today, or this evening. I got to deliver some hay today too. I know you guys said you wanted a video of some, at least I had one comment, a video of some crops that are actually growing. So I'll try and do that and put that into this video too. So yeah, it's been good, busy good. But that's the new tractor I was talking about, the Alice Chalmers 710. And just getting hay and equipment out. Hoping to start cutting today, bale and wrap tomorrow. And we'll got all the equipment sitting out that was in the shop. So I told the wife I need to build another hoop barn to store equipment. So yeah, we'll hopefully get some hay cut today and see what happens. So yeah, I got all the equipment out here. I told the wife I need to build another hoop barn because all this is jammed in the shop and I can't work on anything. So yeah, the question is now, what am I going to use for round baling? Because like I said, the 7060 is not operating right now. It's split in half, clutch is out of it. We took it to them actually in May because we bought the 8070. We use that for tillage. We took it to them in May and I told him I need it back before haying season because it's my round baling tractor. He got it all split, tore apart, and then of course by the time he jumped through all the hoops trying to get the parts, everything lined up, time the parts get ordered, they get them here, you know, you don't quite have all the parts. So I actually had to call and order more parts just this week. So I'm like, shoot, I got to order more parts this week. I got at least a week before they're going to come in. Then he gets, you know, mechanic gets them back together. It's just, we're pushing into July easily before I get that tractor back to even start round baling. So, I decided that I want to buy I need a backup tractor for round baling. Cause I can't be in this predicament again. If the baler goes down, that's one thing. You know, I can work on that myself, get it fixed and everything, but I just don't feel confident enough to work on like the 7060 splitting the tractor. So, I decided that I need a backup baling tractor, and I want to get a 9-foot disc spine. Not sure when that's going to happen, but eventually I want to go to a bigger hay bind anyways, probably a 9-foot or 10-foot disc spine so I can get back in the woods and stuff. So if I do that, I'm going to need another tractor to run that, and then 7060 can stay on the round baler or whatever. So I was kind of looking around. I didn't plan on buying anything until probably next year, but with the 7060 being what it was, I ended up stumbling across the deal, and it's not orange, but the price was right, and it was close. And that'd be my second best thing that I'd want to get, besides orange. So it's, there she is. International 3688. It's about 115 horse, which is about perfect. If I could have been in a perfect world, I would have liked to be right around 120, maybe 125 or so. Just so running the manure spreader on this, I think it'll be okay. But I mean, it's gonna be, I don't know if I wanna do it every day, which is fine because I can run the manure spreader with the 8070 and also the 7060 if I get that back. So I have a backup tractor for the manure spreader. But I can run the hit round baler with this, and it's not gonna be too crazy horsepower to have on a disc bind, a 9 or 10 foot disc bind. It was for sale. Well, it really wasn't for sale. I heard it was coming for sale, and I kind of knew the tractor. I knew the guy who had it, and he took care of his stuff. I know he did. So I called him up, just figured I'd go look at it. And he said he was actually thinking about putting it out for sale this week. He's selling the farm. He's retiring. So it was right in the price range I wanted to stay. I paid $13,500 for it. It's got 7,500 hours on it, but I think the motor might have been rebuilt already once because it doesn't burn a drop of oil. And the TA has been replaced already, which from what I hear, and it's got the sticker on it for the TA. It's done by a dealership right here. So from what I hear, as long as it is, I've heard horror stories of the TAs. That's why I was worried about getting an international. But as long as the TA has been replaced by a dealership, they'll last twice as long as the original, I guess, from what I hear and read. So that was kind of the selling point, that it had new TA put in it before that guy bought it, and he didn't farm much acreage. So I think it'll be a good tractor for me, round baling, running the disc bind if I ever get one, and planting with it in the spring. It's got duals on it, 16.9 duals. Seems to be in real good shape. I was happy with it when I went and looked at it. And like I said, I didn't want to buy another tractor this year, but I kind of had to do something to run the round baler and or rent. It was either buy a tractor or rent a tractor. So, yeah, there it is. That's not the tractor I was talking about when I said I bought another tractor. The tractor I was talking about was the garden tractor. This just happened basically this week. I went and looked at it Saturday. I heard about it, called the guy, went and looked at it Saturday. Called him back Monday and bought it. So, kind of happened quick. But as soon as I went and looked at it and told the guy I'm interested in it, he pulled it outside of the barn for me to go look at. I went and looked at it the following day or that afternoon. He told me he had somebody stop in wanting to buy it, ask him if he was selling it and he wanted to buy it. But luckily the guy's an honest guy. He said, no, I'm gonna hold it for a little while for me. So the other thing, my father-in-law runs all international case. Is what he's got, 1086, 1206. He's got 5488. He's got an MX240. So he runs all international, all red. So the wife secretly wanted me to get red, and that would be, I guess I shouldn't say second choice, but if I'm gonna upgrade into newer tractors, it's probably gonna be international or case. I just always liked them. Just the price of them. was always so much more than an Alice. But this one I seem to think I got a good deal on. So yeah, that's kind of what's going on here. I'm gonna get the hay bine ready. I'm gonna cut some hay. Then I'm gonna go deliver some hay, some last year's hay. And then I gotta go spray soybeans. Tomorrow, I gotta go pick up the wrapper. Come back and brown bale. That tractor there, I wanna pop the duals off it. And I gotta finish going through the round baler. I just brought that tractor home Wednesday, right? No, Thursday. I was gonna get it Wednesday, but the guy was kind of busy and stuff, so I just got it home yesterday. So I went through as much as I could yesterday. The 3688, the International. I went through as much as I could, but I want to pop the duals off it. I was gonna change the oil in it, but he said he changed the oil already and it does look good, looks clean. So I think I'm gonna keep an eye on it. I did charge the AC and it seems to be working. I wanna put another can in it. Lights I need to fix on it. I don't think any of the lights work, but cab seems to be in interiors in good shape. Yeah, so. So far, so good. Happy with it. So, yeah. Like I said, though, that was kind of a last-minute deal. This is a tractor I was talking about that I bought for the garden. But, yeah. Now, that's why I told the wife I need to build another hoop barn for equipment. Because the shop basically gets chock full of junk right now and equipment. And I can't hardly work on anything at all. Because I got no room. So yeah, get this thing ready and I'll go cut some hay. And I'll try and throw, I don't know, see how long this video is. Maybe I'll make another one today and show you some crops that are growing. We got to check some sorghums too, sorghum fields. They're up. So, and I also planted a field of peas and oats kind of last minute for a guy. I see the hay field down for him. And I put a piece of notes in there I'm going to cut this year, so I should have quite a bit of baleage. Oh. Alrighty, we'll see how it goes.